There have been protests in the American state of Indiana after it passed a law intended to protect religious freedom, but which critics say will allow businesses to discriminate against lesbians and gay men. The bill was supported by several groups opposed to gay rights, but they say it's purely intended to protect religious freedom and has no effect on discrimination. Indiana is the 20th state to have introduced such a law. Well, I'm joined from Indiana by Zach Adamson, the city's first openly gay countywide elected official. He has already addressed some of the protesters a few hours ago. Thanks very much for joining us. Can you tell us in a nutshell why this law is getting so much controversy between the two sides?
Well, I think the biggest issue is that it's improperly named to begin with. It's a religious freedom Restoration Act. It has nothing to do with religion, and it has nothing to do with freedom, and has everything to do with discrimination. The public is aware of that, and that is why we had such an enormous turnout today at the State House.
But in essence, others are arguing that you're just looking at the wrong side of it, that it isn't discriminatory at all.
Well, then I'm not really, there's no real purpose for the law if it doesn't do what they're saying it doesn't do. It is clear that their intent was to target the LGBT community after taking a major loss on the marriage front here in the United States.
Seattle's first openly gay mayor has said that he will ban his city employees from traveling to Indiana on official business at taxpayers' expense. This is a measure, or this is an act which is certainly having ramifications across the country.
Yeah, and I mean, Indianapolis is the largest city in the state capital in Indiana, and we rely very heavily on tourism. We're very proud of our city. We hosted the Super Bowl 3 years ago. We are a world-class city, and that's the biggest travesty of this is I don't believe that this represents who the people of Indianapolis or the people of Indiana are. It just shows the disconnect that the state legislature has with the population at large.
And with Indiana being the 20th state to introduce this law, are you fearful that it'll spread further across America?
I think that the other 19 states that had enacted similar laws, or similarly named laws, I should point out, they were all done before the marriage battle really started to take momentum. And none of them were done during the calendar part of the civil rights fight for marriage. They were really more tuned into the religious freedom of Native Americans and their rituals for their expression of their religion, and not for discriminating or singling out certain groups of the population.
Zach Adamson from Indiana, thank you very much indeed for that.